Hello YouTube, and today I bring you the Voltrik Flash Boost review. Sorry for the long delay. I was meant to make this actually last year, but I just didn't really enjoy this racket as a whole, and I thought to kind of make reviews on other rackets first. But however, now I have more time since it's my summer holiday, so it's time to review this racket. By the way, the Astrox 88D review is coming right after, so make sure you subscribe, hit post notifications and like this video so I can get out really, really soon. So, this racket has a recommended string tension of 19 to 24 pounds of tension. This is relatively low compared to a lot of rackets. However, the Arc Saber 11 also has a maximum string tension of 24 pounds. Personally, I use 30 pounds of tension, so when I see a racket that has a max of only 24, I just think it's a bit stupid and it's just not very like advanced, you know, it just doesn't really give that advanced feel. This racket is the 5U G5 edition, which is slightly heavier and denser than the 6U edition. I personally tried the 6U Voltrik FB when I went to the Glasgow Championships, and it was way too light and I just hated it. In the video I said it was cool because it's a new experience. After I got to play a few matches with it, I just already knew that it wasn't weighted enough and there wasn't enough power behind the racket. The 5U has a bit more weight and power, however, normally I play with like 3U rackets, which is around like 80 something grams compared to this 70 something gram racket, and you can still feel the massive difference. This racket is made in Japan. It has a head heavy balance because it is a Voltrik racket. It also has a long size, so it gives you a bit more leverage. So with clears, this racket is not as effortless as most other Voltrik rackets just because of the weight. The flash boost actually kind of like means that it's a lot lighter and it's a lot quicker. In the past, Yonex have put out other flash boost rackets. I think the first one was the Arc Saber FB. That racket has an even balance and it is very, very light as well, and I actually hated that racket because even balance is already quick enough, and when you add like flash boost onto it, it just becomes kind of unusable for most people. So with this racket, smashes, they're not heavy at all. You can't really get like powerful heavy smashes. However, if you swing it fast enough, you can get decently quick smashes, but this racket is actually oriented more for frontal court players. So who I'd recommend this for is actually female front court mixed players, because they're mostly in the frontal court and they can just pop up the racket and kill the shots off and play very, very tight net shots. So this racket, where it actually excels is in net shot and also kind of drives and just like frontal court play. This actually outpaces a lot of other rackets when it comes to this. Yeah, I personally play a lot of singles and I play a lot of like backcourt doubles. So when I kind of use this for the backcourt, I just feel the power lacks a lot and it becomes very, very annoying, you know what I'm saying? Drop shots, they're okay. There's nothing really special, but I just can't really get past the fact that it has such a feathery feel. It just doesn't feel right. I'm used to rackets that have a better punch, a better weight behind it, kind of to carry the shuttle. This one, it seems like I almost have to make an effort to make a drop shot when drop shots are meant to be completely effortless. So defense with this racket is actually okay because of the actual kind of lightweighted properties of this racket. So you can quickly defend like side to side and yeah, just get to the shuttle really fast. But the thing is, because this racket is so light, and when you get a really, really powerful smash with a lot of weight and momentum behind it, it sometimes feels like it's pushing the racket back. And that is what is quite annoying, because, you know, it almost makes you kind of miss hit the shuttle when it's not really your fault. It's just simply because the racket doesn't have enough weight. And by the way, you might notice that some of the top players in kind of like Super Series use this racket, and they can smash very hard, just like that female doubles player. I actually forgot her name at the moment, but I'll just put it on the screen right now. She can smash very hard and she plays like with a lot of power. The thing is, please don't confuse retail rackets with the actual kind of like tournament rackets, because these players are very, very high level. They have a lot of strength. Their rackets actually might be heavier and have slightly different properties. They may have the option to kind of change it to how they like. So I don't really want you to look at this review and be like, oh, Poison Cobra doesn't think this has enough power, or is very, very weak or something like that. But look at these players, they can get a lot of power from it. So also remember, a review is just simply kind of my opinion. So yeah, you can't really take everything for facts. So that's just a disclaimer. Also, I've had a look at some other reviews on YouTube and I've got some questions from some of my viewers, and there's a wide misconception with this racket and also the Astrox 77. Basically, they think the blue one is this way 5U and they think the green one is 6U. However, both of these colorways can be available in the 5U and the 6U editions. Same with the Astroq 77. Some people think that the shine yellow is one way, for example the 4U, and they think the blue one is 3U or something. But yeah, you can get different weights for each colorway. The recommended retail price of this racket is actually quite expensive. It's £185 in the UK. Personally, with £185 and in normal shops, I'll just simply get like the Astroq ATA or the Astroq 77, which plays a lot better than this at this kind of high price point. However, if you want to get these rackets at a much lower cost than basically any other place, visit www.lt328.com. They're a Hong Kong-based shop that ships internationally, so it doesn't matter where you are in the world. They basically sell these rackets at like close to only £100, which is such a big discount. All their products are genuine, so don't worry. If you haven't already, make sure you follow my Instagram at poisoncobra.ken, and also follow me on Snapchat at kenkarsaputra and screenshot the little snap code to follow me really easily. Basically, if you want more information about rackets and new releases, just follow me on there and I'll keep you guys up to date. So now, let's take a look at the racket technology. This racket is a Voltric racket by Yonex, which means it is head heavy. This racket also has a stiff shaft, which gives you good control and good touch when you hit. So as soon as you hit the shuttle, you would know like where it's going with the touch. The frame of this racket is made from high modulus graphite, tungsten, and black micro core. The shaft of this racket is made by nanometric and high modulus graphite. Although this racket is a Voltric racket, it isn't actually that head heavy compared to some other Voltric rackets, such as the Voltric Z-Force 2, which is extremely head heavy. This one is actually close to kind of like in between the Jura 10 and also the Jura Z Strike. Believe it or not, some Jura rackets are actually head heavy, but just very, very little, and it's close to like even balance. So this one's just kind of close to that. At first, when I saw this racket and saw that it was a Voltric, I thought it would be like extremely head heavy and just lightweight. It feels more even than head heavy, to be honest. And since this racket has a long size, it actually means that this racket is longer by 10 millimeters. The extra length isn't that drastic, but it does give you a bit more leverage, and with the very, very lightweight properties of this racket, the extra leverage does give you a bit more power to compensate for that. So the string I'm currently using on this racket is the Ashaway Zymax 66 Fire. I know that this racket has a maximum recommended string tension of £24 only. I just think that's like way too low for me to play with and test correctly. So I actually put it to my kind of normal tension of £30 of tension, which is £6 more than the Yonex recommendation. This would void your warranty, but my job of my channel is to give you like a fair test, you know what I'm saying? And I want to test this racket to its like full capabilities. I haven't really played with this like a lot of times. However, I do feel that with very, very high tensions, playing with it for like a long period of time would actually crack the frame and damage it. I've heard from other people that the frame has been crushed under like the high tension because of its lightweight properties. But I mean, it's been quite a few months since I've strung this racket, so it has gone down from £30 of tension down to about like 28 at the moment, which is still quite high and is still above the recommended string tension. So as you can see on this racket, I've picked the blue and black one. It also comes in a green and black colorway, which I do not have. This racket has some hints of red and also silver. The finish of this racket is matte, and matte paint tends to last slightly longer than like glossy paint. For some reason, I just don't understand, just glossy paint just chips slightly easier than matte paint. And personally, I kind of really like the stealthy matte look. So I want to clear up some misconceptions about Yonex rackets. Some people think that the Japanese models of the Yonex rackets are slightly better than the SP models or other models like that. And let me just tell you, it's completely false. All of them are made in the same factory. The high-end models are all made in Japan, and the lower-end or the medium-end ones are made in China. The code SP simply stands for Singapore, and that is just a region code, so it marks where this racket is meant to go in like different parts of the world. SP meaning Singapore means this racket was meant to go to Singapore or that kind of little area. The reason for like the different prices of SP rackets and also JP rackets is the fact that it's meant to go into different countries with different economies. It's exactly the same racket, don't worry. This racket uses nanometric. It's actually not something that's extremely new. Most of the high-end Yonex rackets nowadays use it. It basically makes the racket very, very lightweight, and it also retains its stiffness and strength. The frame of this racket is an isometric shape. It's actually kind of this square kind of look, as you can see on the racket frame. And what that does is it actually increases your sweet spot size and gives you a bit more power. This racket, along with like a couple of other new Yonex racket sport this kind of new grommet pattern construction where the grommets only allow like one string through, and basically it gives a bit more contact between the racket and also the string. So it gives you better string tension retention, it gives you better performance because you have more like a direct touch, and also your strings will actually last longer because there is less stress on the actual strings. So since this racket is actually quite light compared to like most other rackets, the feel of this racket isn't actually very, very solid. And although Yonex tries to advertise it as still having that kind of solid feel, I personally disagree with that. Because when I hit with other rackets, for example, like the Voltrix Air Force 2, every hit you can feel a punch. This one, it feels like, I don't know, it just doesn't have that. It feels like almost the shuttle is pushing back the racket, which is kind of weird, and I'm not really like into that kind of feeling. What Yonex has done to try counteract this, they have actually put something called the solid feel core in this racket. The solid feel core is found in a lot of other high-end Yonex rackets as well, so it isn't anything like specific to this one. And basically, it just makes the inside a bit stronger and it cuts out miscellaneous vibrations, so it gives you a better touch and better accuracy. This racket has an aero box frame. Please don't confuse this with the dual optimum system on the Duo rackets. Dual optimum system rackets basically have one side where it's box framed and one side it is like this aero frame. And yeah, one side's for your forehand and one side's for your backhand. That's the dual optimum system. The aero box frame on this racket is also found in loads of other high-end Yonex rackets nowadays. Basically, they combine the shape of the traditional aero frame, which is quite sharp, and also a boxy frame, which is quite blunt, and they make it into one kind of shape. Both sides are equal, and what this does is it actually gives you the speed that you get from the aero frames and also the power from the boxy frames. This racket also sports the newer T-joints that Yonex has produced. It's also found in most of the newer Yonex rackets, so it's not just specific to this one. Okay, so basically a pattern is showing up. This racket isn't showing some like specific capabilities other than the fact that it's just very, very lightweight. The newer T-joint is this lightweight plastic that is secured with epoxy resin and also a foaming agent. It's meant to be a bit stronger, absorbs more miscellaneous shock, and it's meant to be lighter as well. So, on this racket, you have the standard control cap. When I mean standard, it is because you know how the Astrox ATA S&D, they've put out this new kind of energy boost cap thing where you can put your thumb on it. This one's just this typical badminton racket kind of cap thing. It's nothing really special. I mean, this cap isn't bad still. Like, you can put your finger on it, you can kill shots really easily at the front of the net. And although this isn't as good as the Energy Boost cap, it still works. The Voltrix series is actually started quite a long time ago before like the Duro series or even the Astrox series was produced by Yonex. And before the Voltrix series, what they actually spotted was that head heavy rackets gave you a lot of power, but the handling wasn't very, very good. So what they did was they introduced the tri-voltage system in the Voltrix series to kind of counter that problem. So conventionally, rackets in the past before, in order to get like a head heavy balance, they simply put a weight on the top. And that means that it's very, very slow in terms of like defense, and yeah, but the power was fine. So what they tried to do in the past was also reduce the weight on the head and give it like a headlight feel. And what they found was the handling improved, but the power was gone. So at the time before they introduced the Duro systems and also the Astrox systems, they actually did something with the tri-voltage system where they made the top part and also the part at the T-joint slightly heavier and also denser. So the denser top and the T-joint compared with like the more flexible middle part of the frame allows for the frame to flex upon impact, and it gives a bit more shuttle hold on the string bed, therefore allowing more direct energy transfer, a bit more shuttle hold for accuracy, and a bit more power. Whereas the extra weight on the T-joint as well as on the actual top of the frame gives you a bit more handling because like the moment like from here to the handle is actually reduced. But of course, now I still prefer like the Astrox systems, like that rotational generator system where they have a counterweight on the bottom where they improve the handling even more. If you want me to do some in-depth comparisons between the different systems that Yonex like kind of introduced throughout time, make sure to get this video to 500 likes and also comment down below. The general shape of this racket is actually quite thin. It makes it really, really aerodynamic, and along with the lightweight properties, it makes it really, really easy and quick to move through the air. So when you're at the front of the court, especially at the net, you can kill shots really, really quickly. But there are some cons to that. It does make the racket slightly weaker, and a solid punch is significantly reduced. In the past, as I've said before, Yonex actually introduced this racket called the ArcSaber Flash Boost, which a lot of people complain about because it really, really, really lacked the solid feel. Like, it was so weak. So with this racket, they tried to improve upon that with something called the Black Micro Core. It's the first time that they introduced this to a Yonex racket ever. And basically, the Black Micro Core is put into the upper parts of the frame. It is this stiff and kind of like dense material where it absorbs like miscellaneous vibrations and also makes the frame slightly more kind of like solid. So when you hit, it doesn't feel like the racket's getting crushed every single time compared to like the ArcSaber FB. I would say that the Black Micro Core has worked quite well, along with a slightly more head heavy balance to give this racket a bit more power and a bit more kind of like feel compared to the ArcSaber FB. Personally, I think the ArcSaber FB was a complete disaster. It was absolutely horrible to use. You might be asking, how easy is it to get used to this racket? Some rackets, they take a long, long time to get used to. Some are really, really easy. For example, like the Astral 77, like it doesn't really take long to get used to it. With this racket, I don't really know. I would say it actually takes a medium amount of time to like long time to get used to because of the very, very lightweight properties. It's just really, really weird to use if you're using like an average racket that is 80 grams or above. Suddenly switching to a racket that's only 70 something grams is just really odd. Like the touch and everything, like the solidity is completely different, and you kind of have to change your play style to kind of suit this racket if you're not that already. And also, you might be asking, who is this racket actually for? Well, I wouldn't really say it's for beginners because of the stiff shaft. Beginners tend to not work very well with stiff shafts because they don't have the correct technique to generate power. Flexible shafts help the beginners generate power easier, but they give less control. Whereas stiffer shafts need a better technique to generate control and power. Can I say this is an advanced racket? I don't really think so. Especially with the fact that it's only maximum 24 pounds of tension and the fact that it's so light. I really don't believe that this racket can be enjoyed by many top level players, especially like the ones where they play a lot of backcourt shots and need a bit more power. In doubles, you can just barely manage the amount of power for frontal court play. Backcourt is already pushing it. And playing singles with this racket is just, I don't know. I would just say just give up. Just forfeit the game. Yonex is always putting out new rackets, so if you want to stay up to date with racket releases and different things like that, make sure to follow my socials as I've said at the front of the video, and also sign up to Longtang's newsletter kind of email service. Longtang provides it for absolutely no cost, it's free. Just sign up, they don't spam you with like irrelevant information, they just keep you up to date with like the newest racket releases. Shout out to all my patrons for donating every single month to help me produce these like high quality videos, and also afford this new camera, which I'm shooting on right now. You might already notice the massive step in quality, like everything's in 4K, the colors are amazing. Donations on Patreon doesn't have to be extremely large, like even $1 a month, like that is so little. It actually adds up when loads of people go on it and just kind of donate together. And what that kind of does is it creates this kind of like multiplier effect, and it really does help me out a lot as a creator to produce these videos, which actually costs a lot. I'm mainly doing this because I really enjoy making videos and I want to create a platform where people can learn about stuff in badminton. Also, my Patreons get a lot of rewards, from early access to my videos to like personal Skype calls and like signed letters from me, and also like my personal contact information. So any questions you want to ask, you can ask me there. Just visit my Patreon in the description below. Let me just give you a shout out to my current Patreons. Shout out to Gerard Jurison. Shout out to Safer. Shout out to Daniel Lee. Shout out to Kent Nielsen. Shout out to Jaming. Shout out to Sahil. So back on point with the racket. So you might be like, Poison Cobra, I still want a racket that has really, really good handling and good power, just like Yonex tried to advertise for this racket. So let me just recommend you some alternatives. Rackets like the Dura Z Strike and the Dura 10 gives you a lot of kind of like quick handling, but they give you tremendous amounts of power. Those rackets, well, they basically cost the same as this, and especially with the cheaper price of Longtan, you can afford it easily. It plays a lot better than this. On my channel, I like to give you guys honest and kind of trustworthy reviews, so that's why I don't really mind giving this racket a slightly more negative review than other rackets. Because let's face it, you guys are not here to watch like a biased review. You actually want my kind of honest opinion. Thank you so much for watching. Please like, subscribe, and tell your friends about my channel. Bye bye.